The Philippine Health Department says six people have died of heat-related illnesses since the start of the year. We have on the line Ara Perez with that story. Ara?
Ron, DOH spokesperson ASEC Albert Domingo says they are verifying the actual causes of death of the six fatalities. He explains that this may be heat-related or heat-influenced, meaning a different illness was aggravated by the hot weather. Domingo asks the public to be careful, as anyone can get heat-related illnesses. The vulnerable, like the young and old, and even those who consider themselves physically fit. The most effective measures include staying hydrated, avoiding outdoor activities from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m., and heavy activities like those with repetitive movements that can increase heart rate. If indoors, good ventilation is a must, with electric fans or aircon, opened windows. Resting also helps, and if you want to exercise, do it early morning or evening or late in the afternoon.
Maraming mga nagtatanong, kailangan ba may brand yung mga sports drinks, yung mga refreshing? Hindi naman po. Sabi naman namin, walang puhipigil sa ating kababayan kung type nila yun, no? Pero hindi namin kailangan i-endorse kasi ang pinakamahusay talaga is clean drinking water.
The DOH recorded the most number of heat-related illnesses in recent years in 2023 at 513 cases. In the meantime, Manila Mayor Honey Lacuna declares the suspension of face-to-face classes for public and private schools in all levels for Thursday and Friday, April 25 and 26, 2024. That's after the city's Disaster Risk Reduction Management Office warned the heat index in the city may reach a dangerous 44 degrees Celsius. Schools are told to shift to asynchronous classes. Ron?
Ara Perez with that story. Thank you. The National Telecommunications Commission stood firm on its cease and desist order against embattled TV network SMNI. Our correspondent Robert Mano joins us on the line for more. Robert?
Ron, representatives from Sunshine Media Network International, or SMNI, attended the consultative meeting of the Senate Committee on Public Information and Mass Media. The meeting covered the role of media in disseminating accurate information to the public. According to the committee chairman, Senator Robin Hood Padilla, this is not a matter concerning a specific network, but rather an issue of suppressing freedom of the press. The representatives of SMNI reiterated during the meeting what they described as the unfair decision of the National Telecommunications Commission to order an indefinite suspension of their broadcast. Jose J. Sonsa, SMNI operations consultant, mentioned that they were surprised when they were ordered to cease their operations. SMNI's legal counsels, Attorney Rolex Suplico and Attorney Mark Tolentino, also stated that the NTC's decision was unfair to them. The NTC explained that there are limitations to everything, including freedom of speech. However, the NTC did not provide detailed information during the meeting about the merits of the complaints against SMNI. NTC Commissioner Attorney Ella Blanca Lopez explained that the NTC holds a high regard and is and has been upholding the constitutional guaranteed right of press freedom. What happened to SMNI is not about attacking the press freedom, but is actually on the compliance of the network to the terms and conditions in broadcast franchise. Commissioner Lopez added that there may be differences of opinion regarding this incident, but NTC do not act without a basis for their actions. The Kapisana ng mga broadcaster ng Pilipinas stated that the suspension of the SMNI had a chilling effect, but the NTC assured that they are fair when handling complaints filed with them. And that's the latest from the Senate. Ron.
Thank you for that report, Robert Mano. The United Nations, alarmed by the destruction and reported discovery of mass graves at medical facilities in Gaza, Palestinian authorities said they found bodies in mass graves at a hospital in Khan Yunis this week after it was abandoned by Israeli troops. Bodies were also reported at Al-Shifa following an Israeli special forces operation. The UN Human Rights Office is now working on corroborating the claims.
And we call for independent, effective, transparent investigations into the deaths. Given the prevailing climate of impunity, this should include international investigators. Hospitals are entitled to very special protection under international humanitarian law. And let's be clear, the intentional killing of civilians, detainees, and others who are hors de combat is a war crime.
The Philippine government has prohibited Filipino seafarers from working on passenger or cruise ships passing through the Red Sea and the Gulf of Aden. The Migrant Workers Department issued an order today prohibiting their deployment to so-called high-risk areas and war zones. Licensed manning agencies are also ordered to sign an affirmation letter that guarantees Filipino crew members will not work on vessels navigating the identified risk zones. The move is meant to ensure the safety of Filipino seafarers amid heightened tensions and continued attacks on vessels passing through waters around the Arabian Peninsula.